Hey guys, Chris Crazy House here. Yo, I don't know if you guys have seen it yet, but there's a trailer for this new game called Black Myth: Wukong, and I'm loving it so far. If you have not seen it, I believe it's on IGN, but it's also in a couple of places. If you just go type in Black Myth: Wukong, and you can see the official 13-minute gameplay trailer. So you actually get to see some gameplay, but as always with these gameplay trailers, they give you the caveat saying that this is only a pre-game build. This may not be how the final product looks. And that could be good or bad. That might mean that the game is going to be the bomb by the time it comes out, or that they're going to run into issues with some of these systems and it's not going to look as good as it does in this build here. But from the build, I'm enjoying what I'm seeing here. What I like about it off the top is that it is a great focus and a great showcase of Chinese mythology and Chinese fantasy. Something that I've been into, I would say, probably since I was in college. Like, I obviously, a lot of us all grew up maybe watching kung fu flicks, but as far as being into the actual mythology and reading some of their books and comic books, because a lot of us know about manga and animation from Japan, like anime, but a lot of us don't get to see a lot of the concepts that come out of China. And they have a very rich art mythology, art and mythological history that you can draw from to create these great concepts. Like I'm very much into like some of the comic books I've read, like Weapons of the Gods. I've read Storm Riders. I don't know if anyone's ever seen the actual movie Storm Riders, but you would do yourself well to go look it up online. You'll enjoy it. I've read Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. I know the movie was very popular, but a lot of people don't realize that's based off of a comic book. That's very good. What was the other one? I think it was called Mecha Dragon something Tiger. I can't remember the actual name of it. Now, a lot of stuff I read originally as bootlegs, and then I found some English translated copies. I think only Crouching Tiger and also Weapons of the Gods were ever translated into English. And even now, the English versions are hard to find because the company that was bringing them over here kind of fell through back in, I want to say, 2004, 2005. You can still find some copies from sellers on Amazon, but they're hard to come by. So I'm very glad that I have them in my collection. But this game, Black Myth: Wukong, seems to be based off of the Monkey King mythology. So anyone's familiar with the whole idea of the Monkey King and that concept will definitely see this as something familiar. Really, Dragon Ball is based off of the Monkey King myth, the original Dragon Ball series, the one that Akira Toriyama came up with first before Dragon Ball Z. And you can see a lot of parallels in it in the character of Goku. But yeah, this new game, Black Myth, I'm really, if you're into mythology or maybe you're just into anthropomorphic furry type characters, you might enjoy it. It's not cutesy type furry stuff by no means. It's not happy, it's not cute, but there are a lot of characters in here who have fox heads and wolf heads. There's even a giant werewolf at the end of the demo that the Monkey King character has to fight. You get to see a little bit more trailer towards the end where they have these giant gods and giant statues. And just lots of weird things. I'll say weird, but really it's just I don't know the culture. So there are some, the way they do their gods and stuff like that is a little bit different than what we imagine as gods and deities here in the West. But it looks cool as hell. That's the one thing that always drew me to it as an artist and a person who just likes to study mythology and fantasy. It's just, it looks cool. So if it looks cool to you, then you should go ahead and try and look it up and see what it is. So I'll post a link in the description box. You guys can go check it out for yourselves, and I hope you enjoy it. I posted it on my Facebook page. And for those of you who don't follow me on Facebook, I'll post a link to that as well. So you guys can follow me on social media. It might be something that you guys enjoy seeing. I always try to post new games or just artwork or animation that I find interesting, that I find online that a lot of you just might not know about. But I try to keep my ear to the streets in that regard. I like learning about new technologies that they use in games and whatnot. So that is something that I still keep in touch with, even though I don't play as many games as I want to. But I'm always interested in the new things that are coming out. So you guys go check it out and let me know what you think about it in the comments section. I really want to hear what everyone else has to say about it, especially if you're a fan of Kung Fu movies or just a fan of Chinese mythology and fantasy. And also for my black artists and animators out there, I hope this gives you some inspiration to see that, yes, you can grab hold of your, maybe your African mythology or even your African American mythology, because there is some of that stuff that's been built up here in America through oral traditions where slaves and black people that lived here in the West have kind of passed down stories. That's something that I would like to incorporate more into my art and my animations as well. So I hope that this gives you some inspiration. If you don't have any, think about it. Maybe you want to go look up some African mythology and build a story around that. Anyway, this is Chris Crazy House signing out. Peace.